Right, guys, so the moment I've been waiting for. Not only have I found my GoPro, which is here, but we are out trailing three generations of SCX10. Remember to get that for you? Oh yeah. Sorry, we just brought the two out, yeah. He died. But this is the original Jeep, the SCX10-1. Here comes the SCX10-2. And here comes the 3.
No, it needs to be right.
There it is, guys. Three gens of SCX10. Let's go.
Add 10 pounds to it. Hold it, there. I've got squashy there.
Yep.
What's that? I've watched them both. They
both look
really good.
This ain't good. Ugh. That was a good catch, wasn't it? Jesus. The river's up to banks. Oh. Nearly went in then.
Yeah. I think we're going to have to drive across that.
Right around there.
Yeah, we can't get across here.
Might just follow this line now, innit? But between the rain and the snow, it looks like we've flooded out on one of our regular trail routes. But makes an interesting swim session. Receiver issue?
Because his radio is next door.
Three, two, one. It is a very efficient tool, that dig, isn't it? It's not just like a gimmick on there, it's an actual...
They do work.
Yeah. I didn't think you'd used it when you first started rolling off. I thought you should have put your dig on, you're going to flip, and then it will lock.
It's a bit slow to come on, it didn't come on that way, yeah.
It's got like a pump cord.
Yeah.
You pump it on the front,
yeah.
Run it down to your back, down the little pulley, and then back down the front. And mine should...
Thank you. Looks like we're getting flooded out a bit. Oh well, we'll try this route. Put those joys down. Hey! Got no joys driving them through this, they'll just go whoop, power boating. I think it's going to get impossible here.
Lost it.
Slip on the ice on that one. That's me, I like to be close when driving stuff like that. I can't do like Dave and just stand away and fly through it.
I was a bit, that's going to go, but I didn't. Is that rock at the back?
You need to bring a little hammer and a little saw. And any corners of rock stick out, smash them up. And a saw to cut any wood that gets in them.
Put a couple of bridges along the river and stuff. And
I was thinking now, for that quarry. There's wood in that up there, so.
Or at the tippy bit where we've been.
We could make.
I did try to reverse it back into here to drive it back over, but oh come on, bloody frosty shit. It's starting to get a bit deep up here now.
I've been looking at the radio link 6 channel.
Yeah.
But also the Abseema 6 channel.
Yeah.
The Abseema's like 80 odd quid. But the receiver will walk through.
You've never really come with that Abseema, have
you?
No. I'm actually wondering.
No, not until he smashed the tree, but I couldn't set it in, but then it's still run, it's still driving.
You've got no water for them, have you?
I need to have the control.
This is the bit we can't get that way.
Yeah, it is, yeah. Yeah, so. Wanted to winch up it, didn't it, Dan?
Yeah.
No way, otherwise.
But you can just come over that little brow and then it just drops down nicely on there.
I did it last time, that's where I got it.
They've got a battery failure at half of the hill. If you want, you want.
Mine always seemed to go on a hill.
Well, it will, I suppose, won't it, though?
Yeah, where you need to use the power. Yeah.
looking all right until we got to there, and it's just going to look all right.
Put on again. I don't like that bit. I think I went the wrong way then.
I'm trying to go in with the straight down.
Yeah. Have you got brass on the front, or is it just the rears on that?
No, it should come this week.
So you're having it on the front as well?
Yeah.
Because you can get like the cross members quite your front and rear, they do them in brass as well as alloy.
They do them, yeah. So I figured I'd get the actual knuckle arm itself.
Yeah.
Rather than go for the outer bits, you know. And see how that does. Because they are pretty nose heavy these anyway.
Got myself kind of lodged. I think it's just a power moment, all or nothing there, innit?
Yeah.
Well, I'll slip off.
Try it.
Yeah.
Right.
Would have gone slow. I think back end would have just got dragged off there.
Yeah, I think you'd have lost that, yeah.
Ooh.
Same as you. Needed power at the end.
Motor
again?
Aye.
There's no motor.
Is your
steering still
working? Steering still. Speed control flashing, it sticks
out
like
that.
I'm fucking fed up
with
that.
It's not radio.
No.
Speed control.
I'm getting fed up with the fucking thing, that one.
It's either speed control or motor or something, isn't it?
Nothing but trouble I've had with that.
It's always electrics as well, isn't it? Now mechanical.
1080 in that.
1080 and that's not working.
1080, it's flashing, it sticks out like that. Switch it off. Switch it back on. Beep, beep.
Could it need reprogramming or something on the card with it being the 1080?
No.
No?
Shouldn't do.
It's a brand new one I put in there. Same one of them cheap ones that we've got. Something down there.
They might splash out and get yourself some home hobby motors.
Yeah.
Alright, it might be like 40 odd quid.
No, you've not got port holes.
Further down.
Yeah.
Might have to cross here today. Rivers are just raging. Nowhere to drive. So yeah, Dave's having a few issues with the 10-2's cut out. So I've let him run the SCX10-1 for a bit. And I'll film off my phone because my GoPro died. What a day. There's no weight in it now, so it gets a bit like slippy in places. Easy peasy. Love Jeeps, me. As with my SCX10-2 was a Jeep. Might get a Jeep body for it. Not the Cherokee, the Wrangler. I love Wrangler Jeeps. I've got to be one of the only people who get excited when Axial bring out a new truck and it's a Wrangler Jeep. I love them. Oh. Beautiful cars.
Do we try it?
Well, oh shit.
Go for it.
Go for it, John. No. Come on, little paddle steamer. What a day. Overflowing rivers. Got bloody banks of like landslides on our path. Can't go that way. It's snowing, it's cold. Oh, but I love it. So far the hobby. Well, now I'll get to the bottom of the landslide in case they fall off, I'll catch them. All right, it's a slightly different route there then, isn't it?
Stop. You know your truck carries on when you stop pressing the trigger?
Does it?
Yeah.
I know I do need to set it up because I pulled receiver out my drift car. So it is technically set up for my drift car at the minute. Nicely done.
Come this way.
Spinning around, maybe we're caught.
When I first opened the kit, I saw them mirrors.
I thought, oh, it's got my pop, didn't it? I thought they were polite.
Mirrors, don't they?
Yeah. Oh dear. It's good actually filming. This is like what I used to do on my handycam. I might have to come out one day without my truck and just come out with the lads and film them trail. And Dave's on my 10-1 at the minute. And I'm actually just enjoying watching. Nice little nudge bumper to bumper just to help out there.
Like, oh, come on. Yeah.
Seriously, guys, Paul has mud on his truck. He really does. Yeah, this truck normally stays gleaming throughout the whole trails. But he's actually got dirt on it. What, that other side? Look at us all getting excited over a bit of dirt on Paul's truck. We are all convinced he polishes it though. Wet, slippy rock though as well, isn't it?
It's mud slingers. They're called mud slingers.
I think that could be a bit of a hint, that, couldn't it?
Yeah. Just a little.
We'll get up the rock.
Hello. Big boys and their toys.
Oh yeah.
Look on the wet rock. Imitation wind.
They're good.
I think Max has just gone.